Hi everybody, this is Bucky Beeman with Realty Growth Incorporated, and we wanted to give you some of the details of where you can look for properties online. The first place I would go to is, of course, our website. Our website we've built in order to have not only our listings, but also listings that are on the MLS. So if you go to the top where it says for sale, you will see there's multiple drop-down options. The first three drop-down options are feeds from the MLS. So if you click on vacant land and building sites, it's pulling all of Minnesota vacant land, not only our listings, but other listings from real estate firms all over Minnesota. Commercial will be just commercial properties within the MLS. It shows for sale and pending options. Again, this is all real estate agents that have their listings on the MLS. You'll be able to see them there, including our listings. Multi-unit is going to be multi-family all over Minnesota. And then the last one, RGI's listings. Now this drop down is specifically our listings at the real estate firm. So you are not seeing anyone else's listings on this drop down. Another place to keep an eye on is what most people know as the number one place to search for real estate, LoopNet. They've done a really good job of just building out their search platform. The one downfall I'll say with LoopNet is they charge brokers to list on this platform, so you won't get all brokers to list every single property because it is relatively expensive to have every single property. That's why you see all of these locks, and real estate agents have to pay to get their listings to be shown on there. So what you'll often find is they'll rotate, like our firm will rotate what listings are live and what listings are not live or hidden behind a lock. Another one to look for is the MNCAR Commercial Association of Realtors. They have what's called the MNCAR Exchange, and notice on this drop down it says public commercial listings. So here you can see, which is mainly focused on the metro listings around the metro area, but they have started to recognize other markets such as Rochester, and this is another place you can list. This was originally built by an association in the Twin Cities area that started with building a database from different brokers in the Twin Cities area, and then over time they've expanded into other markets. And now newer and more popular, it seems like every single month, is Crexie. Again, Crexie charges us to list, so you won't always see every listing from a firm, but I will say they are getting fairly popular. We're seeing more and more real estate agents list properties. I just typed in Rochester and you'll see several on there. And then one to never forget about, because it is used from time to time, is Craigslist. I'm always surprised when you go into a Craigslist, they have a drop down for office and commercial. You'll often see for lease or for sale by owners there. And last but not least, Facebook. Look at Facebook Marketplace, because what you'll often see there is people will put it under the for rent section like it's a actual residential rental, but from time to time you can find commercial. So there you have it. Those are all the different search engines we know of when looking for listings in the Southeast Minnesota market. Thank you for listening.